Hey and welcome to Riga, the ninth race of the FIA World Rallycross Championship. We have Matthias Ekström with us this weekend, which is a big thing because I have hired him from together with Audi Sport this week to make sure that we are on pace in Riga, because Riga normally has been one of the tracks I've struggled a lot with. And it's a track which doesn't have a real gravel, 60% tarmac, 40% dirt. But the dirt, in my eyes, it's not dirt, it's concrete, mixed surface, very hard, and it's not like loose. If you ask Alex how he liked Riga.
Alex, do you like Riga?
Nah.
Nah. Why not?
Like anywhere.
So yesterday we did an event together with Janis Bomanis. We was driving a small bus called Latvia.
We won by 15 seconds.
It was a great picture. Everybody sitting in the car like
the Scooby-Doo van.
Yeah, Scooby-Doo van.
I was gutted because He should have been here. If you'd have been here, the filming would have been so funny. For the record, I'm done trying to make y'all comfortable. For the record.
What's the line you look at coming to this corner?
So last year we was pretty close to this one, but now if you go close to this one, then this corner is it's there.
So I feel like you have to be like out here somewhere.
Yeah.
Right.
Like coast.
So off both of you.
Yeah.
Top of the table. We have three drivers within 2 points. It's highly likely to go down to the last round, but of course this one is absolutely crucial. Liam Doran is up next.
Yes, where am I going? Nick, where am I going?
P4.
No.
P4. Pole.
Pole
race. Race three. Race three is
better. Seriously? Liam didn't choose. There we go. Liam Doran takes race three. Pole. Next up, Andreas.
Good job, guys.
Andreas.
First of all, it's fantastic.
Holding one of his four. So that's three of the four poles gone. Next up, Matt played for Ashley as well.
Nice.
On the weather forecast, it said it was going to be rain today, but look at this. This is beautiful, beautiful Riga Latvian weather like we've seen it many times before. Even though if it's like an old Eastern Europe city, it's really beautiful. Thank you, Baldias, Latvia, Riga.
It's race day.
Do you want the power?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Do you have the power?
Don't get the taxi in here. Don't give him the branding.
Today is a good day because today is the race day.
Let's do it.
It's a beautiful morning here in Latvia and Sabu is taking me to the track. Good morning.
It's fantastic.
Sabu drove us to the track this morning. It was such a lovely pace. Gentlemen, are you all right? Cruising down the street in my C4.
Good morning.
Thank you.
On the driver's briefing, we were sitting in the room, it's quiet, and they put a note on the noteboard. Note, please let the championship drivers fight for the championship. Don't disturb the championship. Sabo, Liam, Robin, me were sitting together and we looked at each other and be like, yeah, amen, sure.
Do you have some energy today?
I have some energy, do you feel that?
Yeah.
Boom. Boom, thank you.
What's up?
We're heading for first free practice. Gonna put the ignition and then start on, and there we go. We just did a free practice and I heard on the radio P1, and that's a good morning. I've never been quickest on practice, all three practices. But no, I was. We brought Matthias in here and he have changed a lot of the stuff on the car. It feels pretty damn good. I've been worried about this track since last year. Since I didn't do well, I didn't perform well. This track has been in my mind for 1 year and it's nice to come here and manage to do the right and correct stuff. So the speed is there, but the starts, I'm still struggling a little bit with starts. Liam and Sabo and Robin Larsson is faster. So I need to nail the start better this time. Matthias and EKS tried to keep me in for work. So I'm more over at EKS to go through everything and look at data and be more focused on my task. I feel actually pretty pumped today. Like I want to do something big, you know? And I think Yeah, it's a decisive day, like, because I'm in pole position, there's tons of rubber, and when there's tons of rubber in the line, it's more slippery. Okay, you're in pole position, so you still are on the inside, but you have less grip than, I would say, 3 and 5 especially. It's a chance that they win the start, and then we need to manage on the joker. Let's do this.
Explain to me.
I'm gonna explain to you. I'm having some snacks. Winning! We just did Q2, we finished 6th. So we are 4th overall. A bit sad because we never got to show our pace because my starts weren't good enough to be up front and showing off. But the good thing is that we are in front of Kevin and Timmy. Timmy was actually unfortunate hitting the wall in turn 2. Yeah, he tried to go around the outside, got squeezed and was unlucky. But the good thing now, you know, you all know Captain America, this is the guy. So this is the wife of Krilla.
Yeah.
And she have made like tights for girls with Bakkerud on the side, my number and the stripes of 13 here, the stripes and the color of our car, Kraft.
Yes.
Latvian brand, go and check it out. We will link in the description somewhere. And should we make tights and sell it online? Comment below. Nauro is here. He has been standing outside my tent for a while. Said he can't bring his snack box into the paddock because the guards are very hard and strict on bringing food inside. So we have to go outside to get the snack box. But the most important thing is that we get snacks so we stay happy. First of all, the box is great with my color, monster sticker, number, Snackerud. Is it Latvian snacks?
Yes.
Oh, and this is like proper snaps or what? Riga black balsam. This is very good but also very bad for hangover, I've heard.
Some Audi candy.
Oh, this is cool. Well, I say thank you very much. Paldies, paldies.
Good luck tomorrow.
Thank you very much.
Hope to see you on the top step of the podium.
I hope so too. We need to take a picture together.
Okay.
Yeah. All right?
Let's do it.
Give me a snack.
Back. Do anybody miss Dave? Comment below. Mystery. Feeling a little bit bummed too, because like the speed was so good on the practices. I won all 3 practice, but I didn't manage to get away in the start, so I couldn't like really show my pace. Sitting P4 is nothing you should be bummed about, but I was like really satisfied with the car. I didn't think that we were on dry gonna be very fast like today, and tomorrow it's wet, so it's a whole nother day. You never know if you are gonna be really quick, so that's the game. Hey, merci beaucoup.
That was a good day today.
Yeah, it was race day.
Yeah, nice to be back with you and Andreas.
Yeah, same.
Yeah, good tomorrow job. We kick ass.
Flat out.
Flat out.
Yeah, we're ready.
Bakkerud, Snackerud, I don't know. That's for the whole team. Greetings from Latvia. One okay. Salty, one sweet. I made it myself. Number 15, you see?
So which one is sweet and which one is salty?
This one is salty, this is sweet.
Oh, okay, I can see
you
that.
You take probably
yeah, five. I only take this one. Thank you.
Welcome it's, in Latvia.
Thank you very much. Baldies.
You calm down.
No, that was the best comment of the day, because that felt like, oh. And then the next practice again, P1. I was watching and we didn't do many changes. And P1. And I thought, oh, now I start to feel a bit more relaxed. So we'll try and keep it up for tomorrow. And as long as we score more points than the competitors, I will be happy. If it's 1 or 2 or 10 or 30, I don't care. As long as it's one more.
Thank you for today.
This is actually the last time I put the race suit on in this race trailer this year. That's sad. Last day we have the awning, the RX Cartel, the home of RX Cartel.
Done. I'm out of here.
Come on. Alex, tell us, now when the season is coming to an end, all the hard work we have done, how was it?
I'm happy it's over.
No, but we had fun. The RX Cartel this year in Europe looked very well. We are the only team with grass mats. We're very happy. That's a big swim.
Did a rebound, yes.
Yeah, okay.
Since it's raining this morning, we are doing big changes on the setup, so especially on clicks. No springs.
No springs.
No springs.
Maybe bars.
I don't know. Yesterday I forgot my insole soles.
I forgot my soles.
And I was walking around in paddock feeling destroyed in my legs today. Well, I have them. Bam, bam, bam. Heading for the Q3. It's rain, it's wet, it's hard. It starts, we just need to manage. That's it. Over and out.
Very much looking forward to this encounter. Race 3, Q3. For RPM, the normal for everyone. You can hear that brilliant start. Kevin Hansen, but Nicky's got a good start too. Kevin shut the door and back for Nicky's going to move across. Oh, shot for the Lamy and the crowd go mad. Bakkerud, if anything, is closed up at the back of Nicky.
I'm fourth!
Andreas, I beat you!
Yes! Finally!
Yeah. I release the clutch. Wheel spinning directly. Just last out of the first two turns. And luckily, Kevin and Timo Joker the first lap. So I had a big gap to Rainis Nittish. So I was driving free. I had the fastest lap times when I was driving, but I lost too much in the start. So I ended the Q3 as P5. Timmy was fastest though. I think it's going to be a Q4 where I start on the outside. Timmy's in pole. What should I do? It's up to you. Comment below.
Comment below.
I know the race is done when you see this, but what would you do if you was me? Go all in, bazooka crazy, take the start and go in and break? When you don't really 100% sure know if there's free? Or would you save it, go with the flow? Push to mark. To you. How is the dance?
No, you do the dance.
Yeah, winning! Comment below if we want Mats to dance more. Yeah!
Nick.
We're P1 in the intermediate standing. It's pretty close between me and Basuska. Tim is up to 6, so he did a mega job. I see another snack box. What do you want for snacks?
Cheeseburger.
Hey, how are you? What's your name?
Sam.
Bakkerud Life, meet Sam. Nice snacks box. Is this your favorite snack or is it snacks you think I like?
Both.
Oh, these are good. You remember we had them in Norway, Hell? 2016?
No one likes them.
I like them.
I like them.
And this is like triple spicy. Crazy. And the ballerina. Oh, this is good. Thank you very much. Let's do a picture together.
Yeah.
Homemade.
Homemade.
She's made it.
You made it. What's your name?
Laura.
Laura. And you're from Latvia?
Yeah.
Last year.
We're together.
Oh, nice. And with the cake now. Yeah. Look how much you've been growing over here. And I'm getting older. Yeah. That's a bummer. Okay, yes. He's nice. Oh, he was wide. Okay, Liam took the start, but he went wide in T4. Ah, I don't think he's in lead anymore. He's first. He went wide in T4. We needed him to do a good result, but yeah, it is what it is.
Yeah,
looks good. Looking good, feels good, it's nice. Ken Block was always saying, it's nice, and I have this on my brain all the time.
Andreas, Copy. Lycka till, kompis. Tack.
The final race then of qualifying from Latvia. And our championship contenders are in here. And Andreas Bakkerud, the world championship leader. Will those points change at the end of qualifying?
Grid is completed. Copy that.
Great start, Timmy Hansen and Andreas Bakkerud, the two championship front runners are going to go towards turn one together. Bakkerud gives Hansen room.
The championship is on the line these next two events.
Hansen in the Joker, Bakkerud on the standard lap. Going to be really close. This is for the line in Q4. Bakkerud's going to look up the inside. Timmy holds the line tight. Bakkerud goes for the outside. Hansen gets it.
You see the grid?
The good thing for me is that finally I had a good start and a good feeling in the start. So we are up there fighting all the time, and I know it's like, I felt that I've been the fastest, so I feel I deserve to be in pole. I just haven't had the start, so.
How is the grid looking for the semifinal? Are we in the same?
I have
you too.
Me and
you.
Okay, I have Andreas and Rokas in semi one, with Liam on the third row with Timo beside you.
Who's in second row?
Nicholas and Anton. In semi-final two, Timmy and Kevin, which is good. Reynes and Christian on the outside. Guys,
this is a shit situation now.
Yeah.
Fuck.
Because if you push,
I could have been,
and you don't know where I am, I could be in front of the guy you're pushing, and I'm out.
No, I think you will still beat Niklas, but I expect him to be side
next
by side.
Next year, yeah. You'll go in the gap, and then I'll be gone.
Because and it happens very, very fast like this.
After what happened yesterday, it's probably the most unsportsmanlike racing I've ever seen. So the Audis, they had Larsson push me off two times. Finally now, he's gone, he's out of the game. I'm back in the game, and we've shown that no matter what they do, they can't beat us. So they're in for a hell of a fight now.
Thanks. Brave, isn't it?
Yeah,
that is brave. That is asking for a different guy.
No matter what they do, we beat them.
My mummy said so.
What do you say, Mats? How do you feel?
I'm so nervous.
Are you nervous?
Even the camera is shaking.
Are you nervous?
Starting to come. What about you, Krille?
Always nervous.
You know what this means. And now you think of all the hours. I'm thinking when we swept the floor in Barcelona, water cleaned the whole thing, and we had no idea on how to put the stickers on the car. And we were fucking this tired coming into Abu Dhabi.
You will manage.
Like
always, you will.
There it is.
Can't block.
Take a close look at the start line. The start line isn't very 100% even. It drops down like this a little bit. So pole position here is really tricky. It's the same for me. It's the same for Timmy later on. But we have seen in the earlier in the Euro RX and in the Super 600, the guys starting further back with no rubber, they had much better starts. So we need to nail this. Okay. Latvia, that Krille Cup in America. He has more fans than what I have.
Mattias for radio.
Yeah, man. Yeah, man.
I'm in Bakkerud. Came here with a lead.
Mattias, är det bättre att stå till höger i rutan eller vänster till rutan?
Ja, lite mer vänster.
Mattias Ekström has given him his final instructions. He's done the job he needed to do so far this weekend.
Nu kör vi.
Yes, sir. Good luck, Andreas.
Timmy with that incredible recovery, but he's got to get the job done here as well. Green light. Oh, great start. Bakkerud. Baczynski goes backwards. Grabs on the inside. Liam Doran up the inside of both of them too. Bakkerud lay on the brakes. Oh, they're all in the wall. The whole pack. Doran goes through. Bakkerud gets through as well. Liam needs to know that he's there. He does know he's there, and he shuts the door on Grano. Perfect for Bakkerud after a disaster in turn one. Came out behind his teammate Liam Doran, and the world championship leader is going to go through to the pole in the final. He takes maximum points in semi-final number one, and Doran just beats Marshall to the line.
So we just did a semi-final one. We won it. To be honest, I always remember whatever happened, but today I have no idea what happened in the first corner. I know I got pushed. Liam looked on me, I looked at Liam, and Liam did like this, thumbs up, you go. Tried to save the tires for the main final. Right now, Timmy is leading in front of Kevin in the semi-final too, and I know that means that me and Timmy is for sure gonna meet in pole position for the final. I'm pretty calm. Yeah. No, it's all or nothing.
All right. So we're on pole position, which is good based on semi-final two. So Timmy's on our outside, so hopefully we can get a good start, come out first. Andreas has the pace to win.
Next time I'm here, I will put the pulse gauge on and show you live. I don't have it now, but I promise it's higher here than when I was racing by myself.
Here we go then, time for the final at round 9 of the FIA World Rallycross Championship. Andreas Bakkerud and Timmy Hansen are on the front row.
Radio check, 1, 2, 3.
Kör vi som innan.
Där gör vi.
We're ready to race for the final time in Europe this year. Green light, great start by Timmy Hansen. Kevin Hansen trying to drive back and moves across. Liam Dora goes inside to try and protect. Timmy Jarno's alongside Timmy Hansen. Timmy Jarno drops, he's in the wall almost. Flicks the car back around and drives back and avoids him. And it's Timmy Hansen who leads.
Oh, come here, Andreas.
Bakkerud drops to fourth.
Hey, Jorgen here, Andreas, Jorgen.
Skronov's got Bakkerud right behind him. And if Bakkerud finishes third, Hansen will be equal on points, but at the top of the standings, and that's how it ends. Timmy Hansen takes his fourth win. Skronov in between him and Bakkerud. Timmy knows. He knows.
Hey, back up, back up.
Debrief the whole weekend.
No,
I think it was a decent weekend for us. It wasn't bad for me and my level. It wasn't bad at all.
The weekend has been pretty good. Like, for 1 year I've been thinking of this damn race. For 1 year, it killed me last year. I was nowhere in my head. I think at the end of the day I did some mistakes. At the end of the day I wasn't good enough in the start.
You have to prepare much more for the next week.
If we start you guys on this level, I still dreaming of the 1-2-3 podium.
Yeah, but I'm a lot more confident for South Africa because this is my sort of track. This
but give it everything.
Yeah. Like this weekend, we had to draw really on our side as well. We might get that luck in. We might have to fight hard like the Hansons did this weekend.
I think this track was a bad track to get the luck at because it didn't really help us much.
No,
because any other track
actually,
got pole.
We were like, yeah, it's raining, but at the end of the day, it's over.
Yeah.
But also, I have to say, like, give it also to Timmy and Kevin, they are strong, like mentally they are in good shape. I think Timmy was lucky that what happened yesterday happened, so he was having his killer eyes today and on it. Just so you also know, like, this is the world for me, 100%. I'm trying everything and I appreciate what you guys have done the last couple of races. It's been mega. I can tell Bakkerud Life one thing, and that's Matthias is back in the sport and he's not even driving, and what happened was that he went to the storage room after the final.
We need to win this shit.
Now we have to make a vote for the biggest burp of the weekend. 3, 2, 1. Go!
It's
3-2,
yeah!
3-2! Andreas!
That's why we call him Bert.
My name is Bert.
My name is Bert.
So now you can explain in 10 seconds why you are the Bert. 10 seconds.
I'm the Bert because I f***ed up the start in the semi and in the final by not remembering the system I've had for so many years, or 1.5 years, and I did it wrong.
And lost the race.
And
the championship
leagues. And the championship
leagues.
Or below the belt.
We're not knowing this.
Yeah.
You never
we don't even know.
This bird can be more important than you realize.
Yeah.
Fine, it's not. I'm going to prepare now.
Okay, give me my beer.